If you are looking for a powerful solution to simulate multiple ECUs in a 10BASE-T1S network, stay tuned. Hi, I'm Matthias Schwedt, product manager of the Vector Ethernet interfaces. Think of the collision-free communication principle of 10BASE-T1S multi-drop networks. Each node has a fixed node ID and can therefore only send one frame per communication cycle to the network. The question that inevitably arises is, how is it still possible to simulate multiple ECUs to such a network? Remember, there is only one node ID for each physical port. A straightforward approach where simply multiple simulated nodes would share one physical access to the network inevitably leads to a changed communication behavior on the bus. Of course, this problem can simply be solved if each simulated node is given physical access to the network. Now the result is as expected. With two individual node IDs for the simulation, each node has a transmit opportunity within one communication cycle. This still works quite well for two simulated nodes. However, it quickly becomes apparent that this is not very scalable and not very flexible. A much more manageable solution for remaining bus simulations of multiple 10BASE-T1S nodes is a new and innovative feature of Vector. The new multi-node simulation feature ensures that all simulated and all real participants in the network can exchange data within a communication cycle. And this is exactly what the applications of the participating ECUs expect. The application expects that data updates that are distributed cyclically are also on the bus in the expected cycle or cycle sequence, while using only one physical connection to the multi-drop network. For multi-node simulations, a new configuration option in the Vector Hardware Manager is available. With a new segmentation element for access to the multi-drop network, the connection between the real network and the simulated network is perfectly implemented. Now edit the network settings on the port. Enter the total number of simulated and real nodes. Set the node ID of one of the simulated nodes. Define the transmit opportunity that applies in the network. Finally, connect the configured physical port to the real network and start your multi-node simulation. That was a quick overview on how to set up a remaining bus simulation for 10BASE-T1S using the Vector Ethernet interfaces and Vector Canoe. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, subscribe to our tech tutorial channel and hit the bell. For any question, don't hesitate to contact us. Thanks for tuning in. See you next time for more interesting content.